ओके, वी आर लुकिंग एट अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम एस सी वर्मा, चैप्टर नंबर 17. द चैप्टर इज अबाउट लाइट वेव्स. ओके, सो अ ग्लास सरफेस इज कोटेड बाय एन ऑयल फिल्म ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म थिकनेस 10^-4. द इंडेक्स ऑफ रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ ऑयल इज 1.25 एंड दैट ऑफ द ग्लास इज 1.5. फाइंड द वेवलेंथ्स ऑफ लाइट इन द विजिबल रीजन विच आर कंप्लीटली ट्रांसमिटेड बाय द ऑयल फिल्म अंडर नॉर्मल इंसिडेंस. ओके, सो लेट्स ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चन. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स ड्रॉ द ग्लास. ओके, सो दिस इज योर ग्लास सरफेस, राइट? देन अबव द ग्लास सरफेस वी हैव एन ऑयल लेयर. सो दिस ऑयल लेयर विल बी, लेट्स ड्रॉ दैट. राइट, दिस इज योर ऑयल लेयर एंड द थिकनेस ऑफ द ऑयल लेयर इज गिवन to be how much? 10^-4 centimeter. Okay, so index of refraction is given. For the oil it is 1.25 and for the glass it is how much? It is given to be 1.5. okay, so glass is denser than the oil. Now they are asking find the wavelengths of light in the visible region which are completely transmitted by the oil film under normal incidence. So let's understand something first. Light is falling over here, going vertically downwards. Okay, light is going along the vertically downward path. So after transmitting through the two layers of medium, the light will undergo interference due to partial reflection. Okay, some part of light is going straight away while some part of the light is getting reflected, again reflected and coming downwards. So this will interfere with the original wave. So both these waves will interfere and the interference might be constructive or destructive or somewhere in between. Now in the question, this statement completely transmitted means to say that the waves or the wavelengths which have undergone constructive interference, it is asking only about them. Okay, so this is asking about constructive interference wavelengths. Okay. Now let's solve this question. So first of all, let me draw one of the rays. So this is one ray which will pass through the medium directly. Now I will draw one more ray. Okay, so it reaches over here. Now from this point it will again get reflected upwards. Okay, for diagram purpose I am drawing the reflection slightly sideways, but actually it does not happen. And again here we have one more reflection. Okay, so this is your final reflection and the ray will come out over here, correct? Now this ray and this ray, they will interfere on the other side and we want this interference to be constructive as per the question. So let's look at the first ray. So starting from this point, we make this the starting point. Let's make this as the starting point. Okay, and we want to look at the interference at these two points. How much path difference do they have at that point? Okay, so let's look at the red one. So this red one will travel how much distance? Only the thickness of the oil layer. So let's, for symbolic purpose, let's say the thickness is equal to t. Okay, so the path traveled by this red colored wave will be how much? T. Okay, so the red colored wave is traveling path T, but since it is passing through the layer of oil, the optical path will be different. The optical path will be equal to mu multiplied by T. So we multiply the index of the oil layer over there. What about the second ray, green one? Okay, so the green layer is passing through the oil three times, 1, 2, and 3. So the path traveled by the green ray will be 3 times t. Okay, but again since it is passing through a refractive index 1.25, we need to multiply the refractive index 1.25 over here. Now there's one more complexity over here. See, oil is having index less than that of glass. So when the light ray is undergoing reflection at this point, So because of that reflection, the phase will change by pi. Since the phase is changing by pi at this point, we need to add one more path difference of lambda by 2 to the green ray. Okay, because of this particular reflection, the path will get increased by lambda by 2. Because of this reflection, there will be no change in path, because during this reflection the light is trying to go from oil again back into air. Okay, so from rarer denser medium to rarer medium, no change in phase. But during this reflection, from rarer medium to denser medium, there will be a phase change. So that's why we have this lambda by 2. So we have to find the path difference between them. Okay, so your optical path difference will be how much? So optical path difference delta L will be 3t into 1.25 plus lambda by 2 minus 1.25 into t. So what do we obtain? We obtain 2t into 1.25. So 1.25 into 2 will be 2.5t plus lambda by 2. This is your optical path difference. Now for constructive interference as per the question, okay, we want the path difference to be a multiple of lambda. So let's write this to be equal to, this should be equal to integer multiple of lambda. Okay, or okay, well, let's first of all, let's write down n could be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Okay, but obviously if you look at the diagram, 0 is not possible, 0 is out of picture. So let's just remove 0 from here. So n can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Now what is the question asking? Find the wavelengths of light in the visible region which are completely transmitted. So basically we have to find lambda. Okay, so let's rearrange our equation. So 2.5t equal to 2n minus 1 lambda by 2, that's what you will get. Okay, so lambda will be equal to 5t divided by 2n minus 1. Now let's put the value of t. T is equal to 10 power minus 4 centimeter. Okay, so this is equal to 5 divided by 2n minus 1 into t is 10 power minus 4 centimeter or 10 power minus 6 meter. Okay, I could rewrite this as 5000 nanometer divided by 2n minus 1. That's your wavelength lambda. Okay, now we just need to check what should be the values of n for constructive interference in the visible range. So first of all, what's your visible range? 400 to 750 nanometer. So your wavelength should be less than equal to 750 nanometer, greater than equal to 400 nanometer, right? That's what is given. So let's just put the value of lambda. So 400 nanometer should be less than equal to 5000 by 2n minus 1 less than equal to 750. Okay, so let's check the left part of the inequation. So for this part, 400 less than equal to 5000 by 2n minus 1, 0 will get cancelled out. Okay, so 2n minus 1 less than equal to 50 by 4, that is 25 by 2, and that is equal to 12.5. so 2n minus 1 less than equal to 12.5, or 2n less than equal to 13.5, or then n should be less than equal to how much? 13.5 by 2. So you get 6.75, correct? N should be less than equal to 6.75. Now for the right hand side, for this part, so 5000 by 750 should be less than equal to 2n minus 1. I have just taken this part on the other side and brought 750 in the denominator. Okay, so 0 will get cancelled out. 25 times 3 is 75, 25 times 2 is 50, 20 by 3. Okay, so 20 by 3 less than equal to 2n minus 1, or 20 by 3 plus 1, that is 23 by 3, should be less than equal to 2n, correct? So we get n should be greater than or equal to 23 by 6. 23 by 6 will be how much? 3.5. 23 by 6, so 6 times 3 is 18. We get 5, 5 divided by 6. So 6, 8. Okay, somewhere 3.8. So basically our value of n should be more than 3.8 and less than 6.75. We want the integer values. So the integral values of n will be how much? It will be 4, 5, 6. That's it. Only these three values of integer will give us the answer. Okay. So let's put back in the formula. Lambda is equal to 5000 by 2n minus 1. So lambda 1 will be 5000 by 2 into 4 minus 1. Okay. So 4 times 2, 8 minus 1, 7. So 5000 by 7 is how much? 7 into 7, 49, 10, 7, 4. Okay. Then 0.2 nanometer, somewhere around that. That's what you will get. Similarly, the next wavelength will be what? Lambda 2 will be 5000 by 2 times 5 minus 1. So that is equal to 5000 by 9. Okay. So 5000 by 9 will give you 9 times 5, 45. 555.5 nanometer. That's what you get. Finally, the third one. Okay. So lambda 3 will be 5000 divided by 2 into 6 minus 1. So that is 5000 by 11. So we get 11 times 4, 44, 60, 11 times 5, 55, 50, 11 times 4, 44, and so on. We will keep on repeating. So these are the three wavelengths which will have constructive interference after getting transmitted through the layer of oil and into the glass. Okay.